Let's look at an example of carrying out the pooled variance t-test as a regression to investigate the relationship between these two statistical methods. Here are the box plots for an example I've looked at previously, involving lead concentration in the blood of Egyptian police officers. And we have the lead concentration for 126 randomly selected Cairo officers and 50 officers in the suburbs. And we're interested in seeing if there's strong evidence of a difference in the true lead concentration in the blood. There certainly visually appears to be a difference here, but we could do the analysis as a pooled variance t-test. The pooled variance t-test is testing the null hypothesis that the population means are equal. And down here we had a sample mean for the officers in the suburbs of 18.2, a sample mean of the officers in Cairo of 29.2, and the difference in means was found to be 11.0. And in the output here, carry out the two-sample t-test, get this t-value with 174 degrees of freedom and a tiny, tiny p-value, indicating very, very strong evidence against this null hypothesis. And the output also gives us a 95% confidence interval for the difference in population means. The explanatory variable is a categorical variable here, whether the officer is an officer in Cairo or in the suburbs. And so to carry out the analysis as a regression, we're going to have to turn that into a quantitative variable in a sense by defining an indicator variable, which is sometimes called a dummy variable. But we're just going to let x equal 1 for Cairo officers and x equals 0 for suburb officers. I could have just as easily switched this and had 0 for Cairo and 1 for suburbs, or just use any two different values for x here. It's just that the choice of 0 and 1 make the interpretation a little bit easier. Here's the output, and the least squares regression line is given here, and I've plotted it in blue here, so we could say that y hat is equal to 18.2 plus 11.0 times x, where x is our indicator variable, 1 for Cairo, 0 for the suburbs. Wait a minute here, 18.2 is the mean of the suburbs officers, and 11.0 is the difference in means. And so the regression line here is passing through the mean for the suburbs officers and the mean for the Cairo officers. Also, if we were to carry out a test of the null hypothesis that the true slope is equal to zero, that would be equivalent to testing that the two populations have the same population mean. So this test here, testing the null hypothesis that the slope is zero, is equivalent to that pooled variance t-test that we talked about earlier. Now let's take a look at those two outputs together. Here we have our output from the regression and our output from the pooled variance two-sample t-test. And down here we had a mean of the suburbs officers of 18.2, which for our choice of indicator variable is simply equal to the intercept on that regression line. And the difference in the means here is 11.0, which is equal to the slope of our regression line. And this line's testing that null hypothesis that beta 1 is equal to 0, which is equivalent to testing that the two populations have the same population mean. And so the t-statistic of that test is equal to the t-statistic given here. This one's just given to 4 decimal places in the output and rounded to 3 in the regression output, but they're exactly the same. The degrees of freedom are the same, and the p-value is the same. So a tiny p-value, very strong evidence against the null hypothesis. So we have very strong evidence of a difference in population means. And if, say, we wanted a confidence interval for beta 1, well, that would simply be the same as the confidence interval for the difference in population means. So these two procedures are equivalent. Let's think about the assumptions of these two procedures for a moment. The pooled variance t-test assumed that we had normally distributed populations. The regression procedure assumes that the y-values are normally distributed about the true line. So that assumption's the same in both cases. The pooled variance t-test assumed that the populations have the same variance. The regression procedure assumes that the true variance in the response is the same for the different values of x. So that's the same here. And the pooled variance t-test assumed that we had independent samples, and as does regression. Regression also assumes independence. So the assumptions of the procedures are the same, and they are equivalent procedures. And this can be generalized even a little bit further. We could carry out a one-way analysis of variance by defining several indicator variables and carrying out a multiple regression. And these are all special cases of something that we call the general linear model. And one of the great things about teaching an introductory statistics course is that it goes right to the fundamentals of much of what we do in statistics. And if you can understand the concepts in an introductory statistics course, you're well on your way to understanding many of the more advanced methods that we use in statistics.